If we did not receive enough love from our parents, then we will subconsciously expect it from our partner. Maybe our partner works a lot, or maybe he does not give us as much attention as we need. Maybe his love language is different from ours. Then we will look for something else. We will look for love somewhere else. A married person can look for a mistress. An unmarried person might switch partners often. Nobody will be good enough for him because nobody can replace the lack of parental love. Today, I would like to offer you a simple test that will help you to see if you received enough love in your childhood. Answer a simple question. The love between man and woman, is it a conditional or unconditional love? To make this question more personal, let me ask this in a more specific way. Do you want or do you expect your partner to love you unconditionally? If you answer yes, it means that subconsciously you want your partner to give you the type of love that you did not receive from your parents. It means that you are looking for a parental love from your partner. It means that emotionally you are not fully ready yet to be in a romantic relationship with another person. The love between a man and a woman is always conditional. If you want to have loving, caring, healthy relationships, then you should understand that rules, conditions, and responsibilities are the main ingredients of love. It may sound harsh, but allow me to explain. Every woman wants a partner who is responsible, brave, and emotionally mature. We women dream about a successful man who can protect us and provide for our family, who can be a great husband and a great father for our children. Every man wants a woman who is kind, a woman without drama, a woman who can support her man, a woman who can inspire her man, a woman with a big kind heart who will always bring joy to the relationship. All those things are conditions. We have responsibilities in relationships. We should listen to each other, we should think about each other. We should support and respect each other. All those things are rules of love. We also have deal breakers. In other words, conditions that will end our love. Conditions that will break our love, will end our relationship. For example, cheating, physical abuse, alcoholism, drug abuse, etc. Every person has his own deal breakers. When our partner does not meet our conditions of love, we begin to argue. When one partner does not follow the rules and the expectations of other, then the other partner will likely break the rules as well. As a result, we have two adults who can behave like children and devalue each other. Every partner has his own responsibilities in a relationship. When we fall in love, we follow all those conditions and rules. We even do more than expected. But within time, we forget about those things. If we did not receive enough love in our childhood, at some point we will demand it from our partner. We create drama, we can act childish, sometimes selfish, and we expect that our partner will love us unconditionally and accept our inappropriate behavior. We attract people in our life who are similar to us. If we are not emotionally or psychologically mature, then we will likely attract a partner who is on the same level. At the beginning, we play the roles of perfect partners for each other. At some point along the road of our relationships, we stop our game of the perfect couple and bring our childhood trauma to our adult relationships. We forget about our responsibilities and start taking our partner for granted, and yet still expect that he or she will love us unconditionally. I have a great webinar entitled Obstacles to Love. I will leave the link in the description. There is a lot of valuable information in this webinar, so please watch it after this one. The unconditional love that we expect from our partners is in reality our cravings for the parental love that we did not receive enough of in our childhood. Parents love their kids unconditionally. They accept their bad behavior and keep loving them no matter what. Parents reassure their kid that they are always here for them. This is how healthy self-esteem and self-confidence is developed. When we do not get that reassurance in our childhood, we look for it in our romantic relationships. Because our partner cannot replace our mother or father, we feel that our needs are still not fulfilled. The pain that was hidden inside of us from our childhood is activated again. Now we have to block or suppress it somehow. Some of the easiest ways of dealing with the pain are eating, smoking, drinking, or doing drugs.